Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel. Today I'll be showing you how to install MongoDB in your Windows 10 operating system. And later I will also show you how to create a database and collection in your MongoDB using both command line interface and graphic user interface. So let's begin. Now to install MongoDB in your Windows 10, first you need to download it. So for that, I'll be just opening my browser. And in here, I'll type MongoDB for Windows. Yeah. Now the first one is an ad. So I'll just leave that because in some other time you might see some different ad. And I will just click on this mongodb.com try download community one. Alright. So basically we are clicking this MongoDB community download one. So just click on that. And now in here, just hover over the software and just click on this community server. Yeah. And now here, this available download section, the current version is this 4.3. This is the current one and the platform is Windows. If you are using in some other platform, then you can just choose from this drop down section. Otherwise, just keep this all default. And the package extension is MSI, so I'll just keep this default. If you want to download zip version, then you can click on that and you can change it. Otherwise, I'll just download this MSI version and I'll just simply click on download. Yeah. And now that my download has been began, I have already downloaded it, so I'll just simply cancel it and I will open my download section. And this is my downloaded file, so I'll just double click on it and I will minimize this download. And my Chrome browser MongoDB installer wizard has been rightly open, so I'll just simply click on next and I will just simply accept these terms and conditions of this license and just simply click on next. And now I'll also keep this all default, and that is we are going to install this complete version, so I'll just simply click on this complete. Yeah, and that is this basically they are going to install this install MongoDB as a service, and they will also run service as a network service user. So I'll just keep this all default, and the service name is MongoDB, so I'll just also keep this all default. This is basically the data directory and this is going to be your log directory, so just keep this all default and simply click on next. Yeah, and now they are asking whether we want to install MongoDB Compass also, so I'll just simply click on next. Yeah, and now just click on install. And now as the installation has been rightly started, so I'll just come back once when it gets done. Yeah, so now as you can see the installation has been rightly finished, and so I'll just simply click on this finish button. Yeah, now I'll go to the C directory. So just click on your C directory and then your program files and then click on this MongoDB, then server, then just click on this 4.4 and this bin directory. Okay, so now you are basically in your bin directory, so just click on this address bar and type cmd, that is command line, and just click on enter, and there you go. And now in here, if you type mongo space dash dash version and click on enter, you will see that MongoDB shell version 4.4.3 has been directly installed on your computer. All right and if you just cancel this and just go to your desktop and just open your command prompt, and so in here you are basically in your home directory, right? So here if you type mongo dash dash version and just click on enter, then you will see this mongo is not recognized as an internal or an external command. So this is basically because your path variable has not been assigned, so for that you are getting this message, and you are getting from this directory a proper response from the MongoDB, right? That is mongo dash dash version. So you are getting response from your installation directory, but you are not getting response from your home directory or any other directory. So for that you need to set environment variables. So I'll just simply search here environment and then just simply click on the edit the system environment variables. Yeah, and now just click on this environment variable. Yeah, and now in here just select this path and now click on edit and now just click on new, and in here you are going to paste your path, that is this installation directory, full installation path. Alright, so for that just click on this address bar and just simply click on Ctrl C, that is copy, and now in here just click on new and paste your path. Okay, now just simply click on enter and then okay, then again okay, and then again okay. And now if you again first close all this, and if you just again click on your command prompt, and now if you just type mongo space dash dash version and just click on enter, you can see a proper response from MongoDB, that is this MongoDB shell version 4.4.3 has been rightly installed. So now that you know that Mongo has been rightly installed, so you need to just check whether Mongo database has been also installed. So for that just type MongoD space version. Yeah, so as you can see the DB version is 4.4.3 has been rightly installed, and they have given some build info. So your MongoDB has been rightly installed. All right, and now we'll connect this command line with our MongoDB. So for that just simply type mongo and click on enter, and now that you're connected with your MongoDB, and now as you can see this is basically your IP address 127.0.0.1, that is your IP address, and this is your port number, that is 27017. All right, so this is your port number and this is your IP address. All right, and you know this is the very important to remember this port number, because when you'll connect your program with your database, so for that you need to give this port number. So you need to remember this port number, that is this 27017. This is the port number basically used by MongoDB. All right, and now I will show you some databases that you get right after installation. So for that I'll just simply type on show DBS and then just click on enter. As you can see there's basically three databases by default. One is this admin one, then the config, and another is local. All right, and now in here I'll show you how to create a database. And now in here we'll create a database. So for that just simply type use and now give a database name. So I'll give my first DB, then just click on enter, and as you can see the MongoDB server has been rightly prompt you and switch to DB my first DB. And now in here you need to create some collection. So for that just simply type db dot give a collection name. So I'll just give a collection name student. Yeah, let's give students. Yeah, and now just dot and then type insert. And in MongoDB you know data is basically stored in a JSON format, so for that just write in a JSON format. So write the first name, yeah, and then give a value. So basically in JSON you know what happened is a data basically stored in key value format. So for that this is basically the key, and let's give it a name, let's give Shourav. So this is basically the format. First name is the the key, and then Shourav is the value. So key value pair format. All right, now just simply click on enter, As you can see, the right result is inserted. Alright, and now you can insert a one more name. So let's give it a name, Rahul. Yeah, now just simply click on enter. And now if you type show collections then semicolon and just click on enter, you can see the student collection is rightly shown. And if you type show DBs and just click on enter, you can see my first DB has been rightly created and the collection is student. So in this way you basically use your command prompt by connecting with your MongoDB. And now I'll show you how to use this graphic user interface by MongoDB. So for that we need to install this MongoDB Compass software. So I'll just simply go to this mongodb.com, then just hover over the software section and then just scroll down to this Compass, that is the GUI for MongoDB. So just simply click on that and now just simply click on try it now. Yeah, and now as you can see these are the available download and these are the stable version, that is this 1.25.0, and this is the platform Windows 64-bit and the package is exe. So just simply click on this download button and now as you can see the download has been rightly begun. I have already downloaded, so I'll just simply click on cancel and I'll just go to my download folder. And in here as you can see this is basically this MongoDB Compass, so I'll just simply double click on it for installation. Just minimize this and now just as you can see this is this MongoDB Compass setup wizard, so just simply click on next. And this is basically the directory, installation directory, so just simply click keep this all default and click on next and now install. And now that the installation of MongoDB Compass has been rightly began, so I'll just come back once when it gets done. And now as you can see the installation has been rightly finished, so just simply click on finish. So your MongoDB Compass has been rightly installed, and so just simply click on the search icon and just simply type Compass. So you'll get the search result MongoDB Compass, so just simply click on that and you will see this MongoDB Compass has been initializing. So just maximize it and it will be loading some plugins and there we go. So they just gave some welcome message. If you have time you can read that. I'll just simply close this and they basically gave some privacy settings for which I would like to untick this first option and also this geographical visualization. I will check this enable crash report because that will actually going to benefit MongoDB to perform better. So I'll just simply check this only enable crash report and just simply click on start using Compass. Yeah, and now in here just you need to connect this MongoDB. So for that just click on this field connection in fields individually. And now in here as you can see the host name is the localhost and the port number is 27017. So just simply click on connect. Yeah, and it will connect you with your database. As you can see this my first DB that we have created in our command line, it has been rightly created over here also. And this is basically our connection name student. And now in here as we have inserted this first name Saurabh and Rahul has been rightly shown over here. Now I will show you how to insert or delete in this GUI. So for that just simply click on this add data button and now just click on insert document. And now in here you need to click on this icon. And now you can add more data over here. So for that, you can type first name as we have written earlier, and now in here we can you can give a name like Monica, and just simply click on insert. As you can see, this first name Monica has been rightly inserted over here. You can you know, modify this data by clicking on this icon and just you know, change this name to something else, like you can change this name to Gita. Now just simply click on update. As you can see, this first name has been rightly updated over here. If you want to check this using your command line, you can also do that. So for that, just simply type db dot your collection name, that is students, yeah, and then find. And now as you can see, the three entries, one is Saurabh, then Rahul and Geeta, has been rightly shown over here. And if you wish to delete any data, so you can just click on this delete document and just confirm that, and it will get deleted. And if you also, you know, to confirm over in this command line, so just click type db students dot find and just click on enter. As you can see, the only two entries, Saurabh and Geeta, has been rightly shown. So that's how you install a MongoDB in your Windows 10 operating system, and how to, you know, use graphic user interface and command line. I have shown both of these in a single video. So that's all for this video. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up, and also please share it with your friends. This is a new channel. It will help to grow our channel if you like this video and also share it with your friends. And if you are subscribed, then also it will be a great. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.